Hey guys, we're doing a vlog. We're doing a gym. We're upgrading our gym a little bit. Ashley's back here getting electrocuted.
Yes.
Do you see Ashley getting electrocuted?
I'm getting a good pump for the glute mirror.
This is her electrocution. So all you guys that say Ashley's got fake glutes, she doesn't have fake glutes.
It's actually fake hamstrings. I have hamstring implants. This is an implant.
Hamstring implants.
You know.
But we plug her into 110 volt, and on before the Olympia we plug her into 220. Anyway, we are doing some upgrades in the gym. We are changing out all of our equipment in here to a all booty gym, all leg and glutes gym in here. But one of the more important things is we're installing our posing mirror for rear view posing now. This giant mirror is going up here in our posing room, so you can see the back view. And then we have in the backyard where all the other equipment is going, we have back here, which is super bright. But putting 22 pieces of equipment back here, so we have outdoor workouts. It's gonna be sweet. This is just the start of it. We got our equipment coming in overseas on the 5th. It's gonna take 18 days to get here. And I'll keep you up to date. We're getting closer. Courtney's ladder control. We all just had to lift this to get it up here. But it's almost there.
You good?
Yep.
We have ourselves a glute mirror. Courtney's so excited.
I'm so excited. We're all so excited. Oh my gosh, this is the coolest thing ever.
All right, glute mirror, phase one. We have an update for you. We are at the Contest Prep Center house. I guess we call it the Team Elite Physique Athlete house right now. And we are doing an idea came to me to do a kind of a prep house diary type of thing where we basically give someone access to this house for, you know, a 9-month period. And we try to get them as far as we can on the amateur level, hopefully getting them a pro card or a pro, maybe getting them to the Olympia stage. So we're gonna actually do a thing. We're actually teaming up, looks like we're teaming up with Trifecta, possibly Cutler Nutrition. We've just been talking to them today about getting, you know, the free house here for them, free food, free supplements, and really like help them excel from on their journey. So this is the Las Vegas Country Club. I have a house in here. I don't use it, so we're gonna use it for this. And right now, Phoebe's staying here. That's the prep center right there, if you could see it. So it's really close. We're like 4 houses in from the prep center. And, you know, Phoebe stays here for 3 months right now before the Olympia. Taryn stayed here for like 3 months while she was living in Vegas getting ready for shows. And it's just been an empty house that I've always had. And we're going to now use it and utilize it and give 3 people that opportunity. So we're going to have a new vlog series for you eventually. It'll start next year. And we're just trying to find the right candidates for that now. Arthur's here. He's shooting content today to kind of put out that promo video. But I think it's a fun idea. Might as well. I got an empty house. So no reason not to help let people take advantage of it. You've probably seen this house in the backgrounds of many people who in their vlogs, because people stay here all the time, like all sorts of bikini pros and whatnot are just always in and out of this house, staying here for a weekend or whatever. So that's going to be a fun thing. Very exciting. So they're going to train with us. You'll see that whole journey. They're gonna go to a bunch of shows in the US, and they're gonna have, you know, to be a way to really be able to focus on that. So I'm gonna post those details pretty soon. But yeah, we have Arthur back here filming away. Another crazy day, another crazy idea. So other than that, Phoebe is here. She is flying out to Florida today, and she is going to be with Angel Competition Bikinis doing a posing seminar with them at the Hurricane Pro. There's Arthur in front of the camera for once.
What's going on, guys? Here we are.
So this is it. Arthur doesn't know what's going on every day. I'm like an hour ago, I was like, hey, it was like 20 minutes ago. I was like, hey, we're gonna do this vlog series. We're going to need like another day. We're going to need like another filmer. We're going to do this whole thing. Girls are going to live here at the house. And he's like, all right, I got ideas going. So now we're here shooting already. That's how it goes here. But Arthur's a machine, so he doesn't care. He's like, let's do it. I got all these ideas. That's how it is. So anyway, that's why I have this house, because I do sporadic shit, you know. And I was like, oh, this house is close to the prep center. I'll buy it. I bought it and then lived here for like 6 months, and I didn't really like it here. And so I live at the other house now. So we've had to figure out what to do with it, and now we're going to do this. Hey guys, we are at Carbon Motor Cars in Phoenix getting our car. And this is the new car I'm getting, and here is the horn custom for me. That is really happening. That's the best thing ever. I can't wait to embarrass Kimber with that. That's going to be so funny. Anyway, this is it for carrying around the girls in the new the Bikini Prep House series. So we're here. We're getting it. Hey guys, so one of my favorite things to do when I go to new cities is check out the local gyms. But looks like I can't get into this gym. I'm at the Track Downtown Gym. And I've driven past it, but it looks like it's all under construction. So we're here, but gym is, and it looks kind of cool from the outside, but it is under construction. So we're just gonna go home, unfortunately, and we don't get to try any cool Phoenix gyms. So it's all under construction, but it doesn't look like it's under construction. When I look at it, there's no parking for it anywhere. Oh man.
Now turn left onto the
Bart Street. That sucks. There goes the, hopefully I'll have enough energy when I get home. It'll be like 10 o'clock when I get home. But we're gonna try and make it work either way. Anyway, well, that's my Phoenix experience. Now we got this cool car, and now we are driving home. And we have to stop now. I got an electric car now, so now we gotta stop for battery to charge up. So this will be my first experience doing this with stops. Anyway, well, here we go. I made it home and I picked up a really hot passenger. But I'm showing her the goods. Look at this, I got a fire screen. Isn't that cool?
You know what?
Oh. Oh, I didn't know it did that.
What is happening?
I don't know. It's got music.
Setting the tone this, here.
This is the best part.
You know what he really spent this much money on?
Watch, check this out. You see that little whoopee cushion here? Watch, so if someone's sitting in your car and you want to mess with them, you could click this button right here. The car parts, it's so stupid. Look at it. It goes to the speaker that you click it. It's so stupid. I don't know why people would do this.
Gosh, and yet he's doing it. Well, he's doing it, guys.
Watch this part.
That's what really got me. I was like, ooh, look at this.
Watch this part. You guys, get off the road. It goes outside the car. I'm gonna need you to pull over. And then you could replace the horn. It's so stupid, but replace the horn with, let's see, a goat. So then when I hit the horn. Oh, the megaphone's still on. Megaphone. Okay, here's the goat. Replace horn. Horn sound. Okay, goat. Oh, it does the goat.
Replace horn. You have to click them both.
Oh. There you go.
Guys, I didn't even get the car, and I already know the car better than he knows the car.
All right, what else we got? Let's see here. We got a goat.
The ice cream man is what it needs to be on there.
You can put stuff in there.
What is the button?
You can make the car fart, too, if you like hit the horn. It's so stupid. And then, let's see, old horn? That's cool.
Oh, my gosh.
So what else we got? Oh, that's...
Ba-dum-tsh.
Yeah, so, anyway.
What's the DJ? Like a
Worker.
Oh, that's good. We need that for shows.
When I see someone pulling up, who's in the house? So this is the new whip, and then a boombox. Oh, the boombox goes. Oh, this is cool. When you do the boombox, it actually plays the music outside the car when you're driving. So, yeah, you could play the music outside the car. So that's kind of cool. Anyway, I don't know. There's a whole bunch of like weird things on here that I haven't figured out, but this is the car. But now we can take people to shows, and when you get the bikini house, we can go places and have like 7 people in here. Look at that. So anyway, we're home. I have a really bad headache, and I'm gonna take a shower and go to bed.
7. Somebody sitting in the floor?
Oh yeah, I got the 6-seater, not the 7. The 6-seater is the middle.
Aubrey, this is your seat.
Someone else on the floor. So anyway, all right. Headache, ton of bed. Nice to see wife. Say bye, wife.
Bye.
Look who we got here, guys. It's Phoebe Hagen doing her check-in day and shoulder day. We're blasting the shoulders. She's feeling it, yes? This one is Phoebe's favorite exercise. She says, I want to do more of these every time. Crushing it. And we got a delivery today from Nicole Dehoney. Thank you, Nicole. It's an edible arrangement. Phoebe said, you must eat all of it. Look at Phoebe crushing it. Look at the shoulder caps. Almost there, Shreevi. Almost there. How many weeks out from the Olympia?
Just under 8, well, 7.5 now.
Yes.
Tomorrow.
She checked in today and abs are showing, caps are showing. It's looking good.
Yeah.
All right, back to work. Hey guys, we are at the office again today. Today we are going to Elevation Fitness with Kimber, but we are upgrading the podcast room. So podcast room looks like this right now. We're putting up a whole back wall, make it look good in the background for the background. This is the new like podcast like station desk. So, but they're putting that up right now. And then me and Kimber and Phoebe are meeting up at Elevation Fitness. We're gonna work out, come back. And then tomorrow is posing day. So, oh, and also, you know what's cool? We got our official equipment order is on the boat now. So it's on a boat. Hopefully it'll be here before the Olympia. A lot of timing on this whole thing. Has to ship all the way from, I think it's from China, to Long Beach to Las Vegas, and then be assembled and then move the whole gym around. And it is currently like, it's almost Halloween. So it's like the last few days of October. And we have, I think it says 18 days for it to get to Long Beach, and then I don't know how long from Long Beach to here, and then we don't have very much time to get it all installed before the Olympia week, which I think we got like a week, I'm guessing like a week before, so hopefully it doesn't like delay a week and then it happens during the Olympia week. That happened 2 years ago, and that was really shitty, because when we got our first prep center, or our prep center here in Vegas, they're moving the equipment from Denver to Vegas, and then they ended up moved the Olympia to Florida. So I was fine with being here, and it was no problem if they were going to move the equipment here, but then they moved it to Florida. So I had to leave from here to Florida like the Thursday before the Olympia, because they were still installing equipment, and it totally delayed and messed everything up, which was such a nightmare. So anyway, this one, I'm hoping, well, at least I'm here, it doesn't matter, and there's people here, you know, all the crew's here, and if they need to, I can have someone here pointing fingers, but, so it shouldn't be as big of a problem, but I do want to have the equipment available for you guys, so you guys can come do a booty workshop during the Olympia week, and that would be awesome if we can get that going for all of our athletes, but we will see. It's going to come down to the wire, as always. Anyway, off to the gym, and then posing class, and here we go with posing class. Phoebe's getting her first Dutch Bros experience.
Woohoo!
Phoebe
and it's
says,
Rudy Hood.
Phoebe says it's nice, like a proper British woman.
Okay. It's lovely.
She's like, it's quite nice.
It's really lovely.
It's my first time too.
Yeah, first time today. We're Kimber is working on her caffeine addiction. What are you at? 200 milligrams today?
I've done good.
No, you've done good. I have a caffeine addiction too.
This week,
too.
I've done 200 to 300 milligrams every day. We That's don't good. Need to talk about what I was at before.
No. Grams. Grams. For you guys who don't know what a gram is, it's 1,000 milligrams equals a gram. Yep.
I don't do anything else.
Women, we're going to go get sushi, and then they're going to have a back flex off. They're going to have a pose down. Bikini girls, I got to import these pictures that we took today. They look jacked today. Phoebe's ahead of the game right now.
Woohoo!
Is it Ashley has a pump. She's getting Olympia ready. It's the last couple days before we start cutting a little bit. She's got some shreds. Look at those shreds.
Can't wait to get shredded.
Here we go. Hey guys, guess what today is? Today is Nationals. So the girls are in Florida. We have a good crew out there. Hopefully we can pick up a pro card or two. We'll see how it goes. Nationals is super, super tough, so we'll see. But I'm over here watching the show. I wanted to be at Nationals, but I'll go into that too. But first off, let's look at this protein muffin, I guess cake, you call it. Kimber has the recipe on, but it's a Kodiak cake, some whey protein, Carb Master milk, some muscle eggs, and like 2.5 minutes in the microwave. It's awesome. Anyway, that being said, should be an exciting day. I've been up all night. I think I was up. The problem when you stay, it's almost better to go there, because when you stay here, it's 3 hours ahead. So I was waking up last night. Gosh, it was like, I don't even remember, but last night I was up all night. And then this night, this morning, I was up at midnight, 3, 5, 7, and now it is 8. So they're going to be on here pretty soon. They're on figure right now. Open D, so we're going to be a little while before everyone goes on, but I'm going to be watching here. I'm excited. So I was going to go, but we have this weird thing going on. One, it's really hard to go before the Olympia to get away for that long because you have so much stuff going on for the Olympia. The Olympia is, as of today, exactly 14 days away, 13 days away, something like that. So it is right around the corner. And the crazy thing is, Phoebe actually jumped into the Texas show. So now she is 7 days out as of today. So pretty crazy things going on. And then, so I don't know if you guys have followed the stories, but I have a whole bunch of new equipment coming into the gym. And we are kind of changing the gym around, and we're going to make it basically a leg and glute gym on the inside. And on the outside, we're going to put like our upper body equipment. So we're going to have an outdoor kind of half gym, and then we're going to have an indoor booty gym, basically gluten leg gym. And we're going to start doing things with our team, like team circuits, team glute days, team booty days, that type of thing. And it's going to be really fun, really good change, and good for the community out here. So we'll do that with our posing day. So anyway, that being said, that equipment was already supposed to be here. Of course, it never goes smoothly. It got shipped here on... It's in Long Beach Port on Monday, right? So on Monday, the shipping container came from overseas with all of our equipment on it. And I was all excited. I was like, great, it's going to be here by like Wednesday or Thursday, because we got notice that it arrived and we just needed a trucker to get it. And we're going to start putting it in this weekend, which was the plan. But then I got a letter from Customs, which is, you know, random. You're going to get, they always do like random checks. So it's, you know, it's luck of the draw if you get picked for a customs inspection. I got picked for a tailgate inspection, which I don't really care. There's nothing in there. I was like, that's fine. But then the customs can kind of get to it whenever they want, which really sucks. So there's two things that suck about it. One, they charge you to look at it. So that really is upsetting, because you pay taxes to support customs, and then you get randomly selected, and then custom charges you $300 to open the shipping container to see, you know, inspect your stuff, which I'm totally fine with. I don't want any, you know, drugs or anything like that coming in here, and if they have to inspect it. But then the other thing on top of it is, if the container stays at the container facility, I guess you'd say, like in the port, for longer than 2 days after it arrives or 3 days after it arrives, then you start getting charges. So now I'm just waiting here for customs to go through my container, literally open it up, check to make sure it's equipment, and then close it for it to get back here. So I don't know when I'm gonna get that package. It's supposed to be here before the Olympia. You know, it's gonna take 4 days or so to install that equipment. So I was hoping to get it this weekend. Maybe we'll get lucky and it'll come here next weekend now, but now it's like a guess. So I'm imagining with my luck, it's gonna be like during the Olympia week, it's gonna get here, and there's gonna be no choice but to have guys doing it during Olympia week, but that's gonna suck. So anyway, that's what I'm doing, but I'm still having a really good time. Been doing all these check-ins with everyone. It's been pretty crazy. The girls look awesome. It's a really good crew. So we'll see how it goes. I'm getting check-ins like crazy right now still too. So it's funny, my phone's just lighting up from everyone because we're getting really close. I told everyone to send me pictures right before certain classes. So like figure A, figure D, like if someone's in the tall class, it could be like figure D or something like that, because that's like the final check. But at this point, it's pretty much cruise control. There's not much you can do at this point. They're all ready. So I'll let you know how the day goes, but we're gonna be watching this on the edge of our seats, eating our protein, going to the gym. I'm gonna see Phoebe a little later on today. Kimber, the wife, is in Florida. She does all the posing for my athletes. And so she's gonna be doing all this. She's working with them, and she's helping out the rest of the team as well. So fun day, and I'll make the most of it. So here we go.
Fresh.
All right, guys, it started. We have a few girls in this class. Looks like we have Katie, Natasha, and Brittany potentially in this class, of the A class. Haven't seen Brittany yet, though, but I've seen Natasha and Katie, so we shall see how today's gonna go. Okay, there's 24 competitors in this A class. Brittany's there, I saw Katie and Natasha. So we have three battling it out in this class. I hate when they have good girls battling it out in the same class. You always wish that your girls were like different heights when you go to like a national show. At a local show, I don't really care. You know, it's more fun than anything. But at a national show, it's for a pro card. So it does suck when that happens. But let's hope we can get a first call. This is a really good national show. Like, so this is the A class, and it's pretty crazy how good they are in this class. It's going to be tough to even get any first call at. So we shall see. I'm over here sweating it out.
As opposed to being head on, they're 90.
There we go. 190. 194. 195. 197. 202. 208. 723.
Looks like Brittany got in there in that first call out, so that's exciting.
195. So I got a few picks.
So that's exciting.
This is honestly the one class that when I make.
This was probably one of the toughest classes there was, but I'm really happy that she got in there.
It's the toughest class to judge. Bikini on the NPC, and I move that number on your hip a little bit more. If that's how dramatic you have your hips twisted, that's okay, but move your number so we can see it.
I will say also her hand to me, for me is a little.
And there's Brittany getting over to the middle.
Red bikini.
We have this announcer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who doesn't know what she's talking about? She said, I think Brittany's hand is too high on her hip, and then she gets moved dead center. And then she's like, I think she needs more upper glute, and she gets moved dead center. And I'm like, let the professionals do their thing. These announcers, man. Like, I get it, you're a pro bikini competitor, but it doesn't mean you know what you're doing. Like, literally said only bad things about her, and then she gets put dead center out of 24 girls. Unbelievable.
723 and 197.
So, we shall see. But Brittany is holding down that center spot. And they're moving people around her, so hopefully she doesn't get moved out of there. The girl to her left is really good, though. That's not an easy win here. But right now, she's split center, she's holding,
face that back wall.
And not only is she holding, but they're moving the girl who was next to her in the dead center, they moved her out, so that usually means that she's doing better. I think the girl next to her is probably just a little too developed in those legs and glutes, is why she's not getting pushed in, but she has really good lines too. And the girl to her right is probably posing with her legs a little too wide. So I think that's a pro card. I think that we'll get that one. I'm happy with that. I'm pretty happy with that. And I'm happy. She's actually my client too, my direct client. And she's from Vegas. So we have a really close relationship with her and her boyfriend too. He's actually a super cool dude. He's a pro men's physique guy. He like, when she comes in the club, he's there and he's like one of the few guys I like let at the gym because he's like a nice guy. When it's bikini posing and stuff, I like don't, I just like want to keep it for the girls, you know? But him, he's like such a good dude, and he's like, he cheers and screams for her. He's probably gonna watch this, and I just love him. Like, it's such a cool thing to see some guy that's so supportive. But I tell him too, I'm like, dude, you're so supportive. You're cheering so loud that you make me look like I'm not doing enough. So I'm like just around my wife, settle down because I look like I don't do enough. But he's like rock star boyfriend of the year type of thing. But it looks like we're gonna get this one. A class, got a pro card, it looks like. We'll see. We shall see. Yeah, they're sending her off. There we go. We'll see. I'm recording you now because he. You lost your voice? That's it, dude. That's game over, bro. All right, brother. I'll talk to you later. I'll call her right now.
All right, man.
See ya. Is that her? Oh, that's her. Oh, that's so great. Brittany! Congratulations, Brittany! You were worried. You were worried. No, you look awesome, man. You held center. Let's not get our hopes up too much, but it looks good, okay? It looks good. So you did very good job. You did everything right. I will say, when you go into your finals, put your number on your right hip, okay? Because you couldn't see your number.
Oh, it is on my right hip.
I couldn't see it from your posing. Okay, maybe I just couldn't see it in the video. No, on your right hip.
It's on her right hip. I'm on her left.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I couldn't see it. When she's hitting her front pose, you can't see her number.
Okay, we'll put it on the left side then.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, what's up, James? You fuck? You trying to swoop in on my client already, bro? Yeah. Yeah. You're posing on your right side, right? Or am I backwards on camera? I'm backwards on camera? Oh, okay, because I couldn't see it. Maybe push it a little bit more towards the outside because I couldn't see the number on your hip. So maybe put it a little bit more on your connector.
Okay.
For the overall, you know? Okay, but other than that, it's good. Okay, here we are on class C now. Stormy's in this class.
Okay. I got...
Actually, there she is.
Five of those.
This is great. I think Arnett was wrong on the number. There's so many girls, I'm trying to keep track of the numbers. Okay, another first call out. Stoked about that one. This is a really tough class too. Gosh, they're all, these classes are so crazy at Nationals, you know? Oh, wow, someone came online that wasn't called out. That sucks.
Switch.
All right, we're hoping to get Stormy in the middle here.
And then 235 and 232 switch.
Right,
moving
her in.
At 254 and 242 switch.
Ooh.
254 was Hannah.
And 247.
She was the last, second.
All right, she's getting there.
239 and 247.
Yeah, Stormy's looking really good. I would say she's probably fourth here, maybe fifth. Just a little bit more fullness to her physique. The girls in the middle are just a little fuller than her, got a little bit more muscle than her. But really awesome showing. It looks like a top five. So I think that's a fair call, fair decision. The judging's been pretty accurate. You know, when they're all out there, they're all so good. It's hard to tell. But then when you start seeing them pose, you're like, oh, okay. When they're next to each other, you're like, okay, she is a little fuller. She's a little better, you know. Yeah, that was the girl actually I thought was going to beat her out for a spot. just a little fuller than her. So I think that's where I thought she was going to get fifth, was that girl on the right of her. So this is pretty dead accurate. Sandy's on. So now we're shooting for a fifth or a sixth, because this girl on the far, no, she'll beat fifth. She's just a little softer in the glutes. Even though she's fuller, though. She is fuller, though, so I guess there is an argument there, but Stormy Shape, I think, will beat that and get a fifth place here.
But then when we hit the backside, yeah. I was liking the girl.
So the girl in the red will get first, I think. Second will be the her. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Still really good. Just got to be happy with that. First call out placing in top five here. So, guys, everything's going pretty good at Nationals. Got another first call out, and I am on the phone now. As you can hear, that is what you're listening to all day. As I'm trying to figure out this customs thing and to get, I guess, my x-ray. It's, they said they're going to, I talked to someone, it's like they got to x-ray the container, which is, you know, fine with me, but they haven't set it up yet. So we're trying to get this equipment here before the Olympia. Oh, that's so funny, man. People don't know the back end things. The other day I was like scraping the concrete at our gym because there's like a bag was lit on fire. There's just like all these little things, a part of the gym stuff. But I think when we get this done, hopefully this answers some questions, at least when we'll get it. And I think everyone's going to be real excited for what we're going to be doing here pretty soon. And a lot of this is going to be just for our athletes, like for free for our athletes. But yeah, so we're on the phone trying to figure this out, trying to get that set up, watching Nationals. And having a pretty good day. And then soon I'm gonna go work out. Kimber's in Florida right now, so I'm gonna go work out with Phoebe. We're gonna look at her. She's getting ready for a show in six days. So anyway, let's see what happens this next one. We're still waiting. There's a few more to go. I think Jordan's up next. And I think she's got a decent shot too. I think hers, she's in the next class. So we'll see. All right, there's Jordan in the white suit. I was hesitant about this white suit, but I really like it. It really works on her. It looks really good with her platinum blonde hair. It's a different look, you know, but still good. Guys, I just got off the phone with customs, and we cleared customs. That's so exciting. So now we have to schedule the equipment arrival and schedule the delivery. And that could be soon. If they schedule it today, that could be getting here this weekend maybe. And all next week, them just putting equipment together. And we should have it in time for the Olympia if the guy can deliver it in time, if they can schedule in time. So pieces are coming together. This is going to be really fun. I'm actually excited about this. I don't get excited very often. I've been doing this gym thing for so long. Very few things excite me. But this one, I'm excited about. We're going to get a whole bunch of equipment. The gym's going to be a booty gym now. And we're going to have an outside workout area too. And actually, tomorrow, I'm going to be at the gym taking equipment apart and putting it in the outside with some help and building our outdoor gym. So I'm actually pretty happy guy right now. So all I need is maybe a pro card tonight. Make that day even better. Maybe I can get a couple. All right, here's the first call out. This is a really tough class. And we'll see if Jordan can get in there. Oh, there she goes. First call out for Jordan. Doing good today. This is great. For a national show, I mean, it's so hard at nationals. Getting any first call out's great. This is awesome. We'll see if we can work in. They're going to do some movements on her. She looks good. She's I will say a little, I think the nerves are getting to her a little bit. She's a little fidgety. So hopefully she can relax a little bit. And, let's see. Hey guys, we are here. We're getting coffee with Phoebe.
Woo!
Phoebe's, how many days out are you, Phoebe?
8 days.
8 days out. But we're still watching here, seeing if Brittany gets his pro card in the A class. Oh my gosh, exciting day.
Exciting day.
The trajectory of it.
Oh my gosh, okay. She's in fifth place.
Because only up until nationals.
Okay. One more place and she gets a pro card.
And other competitions throughout the year.
Oh! Front guard! Oh, she won the class! Yes, Whitney! Yes!
Yes, Whitney! Let's take that overall, baby!
Yeah, baby! New ISCD, bro! Sign the wall!
Oh my god!
Sign the wall! She's like, I'm gonna sign that wall, Adam. Yeah! She's like, I'm gonna sign that wall.
Oh my god!
Yes!
This is so fun!
Congratulations all five of
Let's do this every Saturday.
Yeah, this is so cool.
I just want to acknowledge this.
Oh my god! This, I might be careful.
Yo! What's up, man? We got it! Are you stoked?
I can, man!
Are you?
Yo, I get up!
Oh, he's screaming. He lost his voice. He lost his voice earlier. Oh shit!
Oh my god! That is amazing.
The best thing. He's so happy. I love it, dude. Congrats, brother. Congrats,
thank you,
dude.
Thank you. Take that overall.
We'll try to get that overall. We got about 30 okay, minutes. Go. All right, brother. See you later.
Oh my god, that's so sweet.
He's such a sweet guy, right?
That's so sweet.
That guy's boyfriend of the year. I'm like, dude, I could never be such a hype guy. It makes me, I'm like, gosh, is that the standard? Because if that's the standard.
You better step up your bloody game.
Dude, don't show that to Max, to anyone. Sorry, Max, I actually just screwed Max.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm expecting exactly that out of the Olympia and Texas now.
Hey guys, today is a bigger day. We're moving some of the house, my stuff from this house, over to Phoebe's house. We call it Phoebe's house. Because Phoebe's been, you have the record. Taryn was 2 months, you're at
3 months almost.
Yeah.
So this is Adam's school.
Yes. we
Adam's high school.
We put desks in the kitchen because.
Okay, so also, this, you can vote in the comment section below. Or do you think it should be more of an open space, or it should be like the desk in the middle? I don't think the desk should be in the middle, because I was like, that's too high school, not enough home. So I thought, push it back, have a bit more open space.
So Phoebe used our TV, this is under the TV, but she's been using it as a desk. Look at this pathetic desk. Poor Phoebe. Look at this pathetic, it's like, what is that, 13 and 14 inches deep? Her desk she's been using.
Work anywhere.
So we got these desks here instead of the dining room, because we have this dining, this area over here where people eat when Phoebe doesn't have her inventory on it.
Literally
her house right now. But when people are here doing the prep center house, they need a place to work. So we have the three rooms upstairs that they're gonna be using. And then I imagine they're gonna be eating just here, because no one ever eats in the dining table. So we're like, well, we'll just put those desks there so they can work there and then they can work here. Put a brand new TV in today too for the house. And Phoebe's like, I'm excited, I can watch TV for 8 days before the Olympia.
Not even 8 days, we've got 4 days until I leave for Texas.
Anyway, so big day. We're now headed over to CPC gym. I'll see you later, Phoebe.
Bye.
We're headed over to the CPC gym, and we are gonna be moving equipment out of the gym, which is gonna be crazy. They're delivering 51 boxes on Wednesday morning. So it's currently Saturday. We're gonna be moving equipment out into the backyard now. And we're gonna move a lot of the upper body equipment into the back. So we're gonna have like an upper body gym outside. It's gonna be cool. And then the inside is all legs. So we're gonna try to figure out how to space this. And we're just gonna be disassembling and assembling equipment today. So yeah, that's today. All right guys, here's the before. We're gonna be moving some of this stuff around. We're gonna put some stair mills right here. Where these are, and then we're gonna be moving a lot of this chest stuff outside. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of this equipment is gonna be outside now. So leg gym coming. I'm actually excited about it. I think it's gonna be really fun to have a booty gym here. So but this equipment is too big. It doesn't fit through our space. So we have to disassemble it to get it outside, which is a pain in the ass. Take all these weights off, disassemble it, get it to be small enough to go through the doorway, and then reassemble it outside. So it's like playing Legos. Yeah, so not the most fun, but it's what it is. So here's a problem we're already running into, right? So we took this tricep dip machine, tried to take it all the way apart. We took the arms off, but it doesn't fit through this gap. So that's the problem, is this gap, we have to take everything apart. This door is big enough, but that gap's not. And this is like, used to be a bank vault. There's like no way around it. So we take all the equipment apart to get through this, like, it's like 12 feet. And it's my fault too, because I built this wall, if you guys remember, a while back. And they asked me how wide I want this gate. It's like a custom gate. And I was like, oh, it doesn't need to be that wide. Like, we're not gonna put anything back here, and I want it to be like, I don't want it to be too easy to break in. So if I would have made this gate like three feet bigger, we could just go out the double front doors and then out the double back. We'd finish this in like 2 hours. But now it's like the project turned into like days because everything's gonna come apart. I've done so many mistakes with this stuff. I'm not a gym builder. I shouldn't be a gym builder. But yeah, so now that's just what today looks like. But by the end of the day, we're gonna have, I'm gonna do like my back workout outside. It's gonna be awesome. I'm so excited for that. Just work out outside. Bring like a single speaker thing out here. We're gonna put, I think we're gonna put somewhere around, well, right now I think we're putting 15, well 13. So we're gonna put 18 pieces back here, and then eventually we're gonna put like 20, 25 or so pieces back here. So you gotta be good. Oh, you got it, huh?
Yes, sir.
It's gonna be, how fun is that gonna be?
Oh, it's gonna be great.
We got 51 boxes coming. Anyway, that's the day. Take a look at this, it's coming along. Got ourselves a little outdoor gym here. That's pretty good dope. I have a, gosh, I don't know if we're gonna be able to fit all the equipment. Let's do the math here, guys. I think I might have too much equipment again. I've done this like so many times. I've like bought too much equipment and then had to sell it, and like sell it for like pennies on the dollar what I paid for it, because I wanna have too much rather than too little. And it comes all the way from overseas, and I just don't know how it's all gonna fit. So I think I messed up. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh yeah, I have 13 coming. So I have 10 max I can fit out here on top, so I have 3 extras it looks like. Here we go again. Well, welcome to my life. Hey guys, check this out. We have an outdoor gym being built. It's pretty sweet. But I just realized I have too much equipment ordered, because they put in back here now on this wall. Looks like there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it looks like there's room for 12 to 13 pieces tops around the wall. But on this back wall, we have this door and the electrical box, so that takes out like, this whole thing takes out like 4. So we're probably at best gonna be able to fit like 10 pieces, but I already have two. So that means we have somewhere between 7 and 9 more probably pieces of equipment, and I have 13 that I paid for that is coming. So looks like I did it again and I'm wasting money again, and I have too much equipment coming, and I'm gonna have to sell it on like Craigslist for like pennies on the dollar, which I did last time. building stuff, I've wasted so much money. I've put walls up that I took down, or I've took walls down, demoed them, and then put them back up because it actually was good. Like stupid stuff like that. Like over the years is like so much wasted money. And but there's no way of doing it. It's like, unless you have a crystal ball or something, there's like no, like it's so annoying. But anyway, yeah, I'm happy we're getting this outdoor gym. I'm gonna work out here today to make me feel better about losing what are 5 pieces, whatever, worth of equipment money. But isn't that cool? Indoor gym for legs, outdoor gym, upper body. I'm stoked about that.
Hi, Kimber.
I gotta clean. Now we gotta clean the whole gym. All of it. So 6,000 square feet of mat, something like that. And you have to clean it, knowing you have to get it dirty again on Wednesday so you're filthy. Because if you don't do that, then you're gonna cover the dirty spot with equipment, and then you can't get to it. So you clean it spick and span, and then just to get it dirty again, and it's heartbreaking every time there's dirt on it. Because I have to use this stupid machine, which when I use this machine and I clean, I think to myself, you know what? If I wasn't fat when I was a kid, like a little kid, I would have never gotten into weightlifting, and this could have been my life. So I can't complain when I might do it once in a while. What if that would have happened? Would you still marry me if I was a floor cleaner?
I probably wouldn't have met you.
I probably would have cleaned your floor. They're
like, who's this guy?
That floor cleaner, what is his name?
I probably still would have.
Well, I'm getting an all female cleaning crew in the house, I'll tell you that. That's all.
Yeah, it's a female cleaning crew of one.
Yeah, she won't let me get her cleaning. Gonna help me clean this gym. You know what's crazy is Max flies in on Tuesday night, Phoebe's Max, and he like volunteered to help me, and I'm like, because he gets in Tuesday night, so Wednesday we're doing all the equipment, and I'm like, Max, I'm not gonna let you help me put gym equipment together when you just got back. You haven't seen your, I mean, he's been with Phoebe for like 5 years. Like, you've been seeing her for 3 months, dude. You're gonna help me the whole day moving Jimmy Griffin around. I'm not gonna let you do that. He's like, I'm coming. So, he's like, I missed you just as much as Phoebe.
The bromance ignites.
It's so funny. I get along with the boyfriends. Anyway, this is my life right now. This is the life I chose. You know what makes me mad is when I do this stuff and I realize I don't make any money off of Jim? It's where it really makes me. This gym takes so much time. I've made $0. It's only cost me money. I've never made money at this gym. That's so stupid. I keep doing it. Don't stop.
But look at that floor. Before. After. Good job.
My bloodline.
I think you can quit your day job.
I mean, the gym business isn't making any money. Gotta start something. What's up, Phoebe?
Speak of the devil.
We're vlogging right now, too.
I was supposed to train. What the hell?
Come here. We're gonna follow Phoebe. Phoebe, you gotta come outside. Come here. Phoebe's the best. With reactions. I was watching America's Got Talent with Phoebe once, and she's like jumping off the couch the whole time. She's like, oh, wow. And I was like, Max is like, dude, she's so hard to watch TV.
Yeah, she hates it. Oh, it does look cool though. And then it's gonna have a, well, something in the middle.
Yeah,
grass, but not real grass.
Yeah, artificial turf all the way down.
Fake grass. We do that in America.
So all the equipment's coming on Wednesday?
Yep, Wednesday.
Exciting. I can't wait.
Cool, right?
It's chilly out here.
Yeah, we're going to go get a speaker, and then we're going to work out outside.
What, today?
Yeah.
Ooh. It's actually not that cold either. It
is cold, but it's not that cold. Ashley, no, she doesn't like the cold. She's a hot person. She is 74 as her temperature at her house.
I would die.
It's crazy. I know.
I would die.
All I would do is sweat when I used to stay at her house all the time.
74?
Yeah. I would stay at her house and like, all right, better get used to
like
it.
An hour, I'll blast the heat for like 80 and then like turn down because I'm so cold.
Her boyfriend is from Brazil, so he's used to hot as well.
No,
so
I like it pretty hot. Yeah,
you're actually pretty hot at the house. I went there yesterday. It was pretty hot.
I'm sweating. Yeah, I like it really
anyway.
No, I like it.
Anyway, that's our discussion.
To be fair, I like to be cozy.
Up next is equipment. We're getting outdoor speakers at the party. Embarrassed.
Do you need help, sir?
It's kind of cool for outdoor speakers for the gym, for the outside workout area. We're gonna do that, and then we're gonna get, yeah. I like the bass on this one. You think the bass on this one's better? Cool. But it has mega bass. Mega bass. Oh, we had it on the mega bass.
Yeah. It's
pretty good. Let's get the mega bass. 2250.
I like the way that this one sounds versus the sound.
Slap of the bass. Mega the bass. All right, we're gonna do that. We're paying $250 for an outdoor workout right now. Let's go. Just like that, we got an outdoor gym. Time to lift. Time to lift. That'll be fun. Half of our outdoor gym is complete. Let's go. We decided to do a glitter wall for the posing room. Thought it would be a nice little add. We have our paint guy coming tomorrow to put paint on this mirror. So Kimber is taping everything off, and I am putting a glitter protection suit on. Here, could you flip it? This is the official glitter protection suit.
Hole at the top is very important.
We just realized how hard, how much glitter hits everywhere.
Yeah, this hoodie down here.
Yeah,
is good.
Yeah, a little ripped. Look at this. It's a snake. What is it's like the longest back. Look, what is that? Everything impossible.
Oh my gosh.
What's going on? Oh, it's like a real sleeve. It's like a real t-shirt. Here.
Whatever brand of trash bags this is, this would be a great commercial.
Oh, the trash can. That's it. Glitter. Where's my...
I don't know.
How do I lose it?
Do you take it outside?
Sad, I'm mad, She thinks it's so funny. There's glitter everywhere.
I tried to tell them.
It sounded like a good idea. And there's glitter every. Can you guys? I don't know if you can see it. And I have this whole wall covered in glitter. And it's not glued to the wall. It's just glitter and air. They didn't put any adhesive to it. I didn't know that. So now I have. Who puts glitter and air? Who does? Who? What are you gonna do with that? It doesn't stick at all. It just sits to the wall. It just sits on there, and it's just getting everywhere. There's no glue. There's no adhesive. So now I gotta paint this wall again. This whole wall is done. The whole wall. And she thinks it's so funny.
I don't think it's funny. I tried to tell you. I've done crafts with glitter before.
I didn't know, and it looks terrible. I would have kept it if it didn't like look so spotty. And then like sealed it, but then the sealer wouldn't look so good, and it looks like this with this nice gym, it looks like this cheap glitter wall. That was so stupid. I didn't know that. Who puts glitter and air in a can? Who does that? Why is that a nice, why is that even a thing? It doesn't say that. It says Rust-Oleum, which is like paint, right?
I've used that before.
Intense shimmer finish, and it says that it's finishing, so it would, you know, be the end of it, not start of it. It should call it Intense Shimmer Start. That's what it should be called. So anyway, now I have a painter coming in on Monday. I think I told you that in the last video how much money I've wasted trying to put this place together from mistakes. Here's another one. This is one for the record.
Exactly. We're only one spray paint.
Well, I lost another one, so two. But no, it's not that. It's going to cost, because Antonio's coming tomorrow for the paint, so. Yeah, but that wall, I guess, technically could have used a new painting anyway.
It did have oil all over it from y'all's butts.
Yeah, girls, when you come in the posing room, you put your oil on or whatever, you're posing or whatever, and you lean up against the wall, at least oil butts everywhere. So, anyway, I'm going to work out now before we don't. And I'm going to be depressed about this glitter in the gym for the next 7 months. Literally everywhere already. I'm like, I didn't even go by my office door. How's it glitter over there? I didn't even go that far. It's everywhere. Everywhere I look. I didn't go over here. I thought I was so creative. I was like, oh, I know what I'll do. I'll do something to be a little different in here. That's why it's different.
It is a good idea.
Probably other people have tried it. I'm just gonna get the graffiti guy to come in here and do some graffiti. That's the answer. Anyway, this is my life. This is the life I chose. It's Sunday night. We're over here cleaning. This is what our Sunday night looks like. She's vacuuming the whole gym. I don't think the gym's that big until we're doing this. And then I'm like, damn, I don't want a bigger gym. This sucks. All getting ready to get it dirty again for the equipment to come in. And then we're getting it ready for the Olympia. Not fun. Guys, guess what? We are how many days out from Texas?
4 days out.
So that's Phoebe here.
And I'm happy because I have more carbs today.
She's got more carbs today. Just doing a quick behind the scenes for this vlog. And she's looking really, really good. Jumped into the Texas show. We did check-ins with Phoebe earlier today. We did check-ins with Ashley earlier today. How many days out from the Olympia, Phoebe?
11.
11, are you freaking out?
No, I'm so excited for it. Like, I'm really excited. It's gonna be so much fun. It's gonna be so much fun.
I'm freaking out. just kidding. I'm not. I'm actually enjoying it, having fun. And we're gonna work out today. We're gonna work out a whole bunch going into this week. And tomorrow the equipment comes in. It's gonna be great. Yeah. So anyway, here we go. We're about halfway done with the workout. Phoebe's seeing new veins. She's like, look, I got a leg vein. I never had a leg vein before. It's Olympia level lean. Olympia level. She doesn't like it. She's like, I don't like it. vascularity. No points for vascularity. So we're gonna end this vlog and we're gonna start a new one with putting this equipment together, trying to get it done in time for the Olympia. We have, it is Thursday now, haven't put a single piece together. People come in on Monday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I don't know, man. That's asking a lot. Look at, it's all in pieces here. That's asking a lot. That's like, yeah. To be continued. Thanks for watching.